gotta go to Coda. You got service subpoena for child support. That was that nerve. You ain't even get a chance to say a word. I know I ain't tripping. Don't your brother got them birds. You ready to bust you somebody? You ain't scared, huh? You know how to play it, huh? I know you ain't gonna let somebody come and punk you, huh? Stand in front you, huh? Straight up run you, huh? You know who got that fight? You know how to use a triple beam, huh?
Inside the show. And now your host, Justin Allegri.
It's Monday morning, and welcome to Inside the Show. Starting out west in the American League, the Oakland Athletics combined to give up just 5 hits as they defeated the visiting Giants 4-1. Heading into the day, the A's sit in third place in the American League West Division. They're 17.5 games out of first, while the Giants are in fourth place in the NL West. They're 18.5 games out of first. The Texas Rangers combined for a 4-hitter as they took down the Red Sox on the road 3-1. As of right now, the Red Sox sit in second place in the American League East Division, but they currently lead the AL wildcard race, while the Rangers sit in last place in the American League West Division. They're over 20 games out of first. The Indians smacked 15 team hits as they defeated the visiting Angels 7-1. At the start of the day, the Indians sit in second place in the AL Central Division, 5.5 games back, while the Angels are in first place in the AL West. They have a 3-game cushion. The Houston Astros finished off a 3-game sweep as they took down the visiting Mariners 4-0. As of today, the Astros sit in second place in the American League West, yet they currently hold a spot in the race for the American League wild card. And the Mariners are fourth in the division. They're 18.5 games out of first. The New York Yankees knocked out 12 hits as a team as they pulverized the Twins 10-3. In the standings, the Yankees are atop the American League East Division. They are more than 10 games ahead of second. And the Twins are in third place in the AL Central. They trail by 8.5 games. The Chicago White Sox got 12 hits in this one as they took down the Rays in St. Petersburg 14-2. The win was their fifth straight as a team. Heading into the day, the Rays are in third place in the AL East, 16 games out of first. And the White Sox are atop the AL Central. They are enjoying a 5.5 game advantage. Thomas Hatch had his first victory of the year, leading the Blue Jays to the W against Detroit 3-1. At the start of the day, the Blue Jays sit in fourth place in the American League East Division. They're over 20 games out of first. And the Tigers are in fourth place in the AL Central, 12.5 games back. The Orioles snapped their 5-game losing streak as they beat the Braves in walk-off fashion 7-6. Entering the day's action, the Orioles are in last place in the AL East. They're over 20 games out of first, while the Braves sit atop the NL East. They have a small half-game advantage. The Royals totaled 11 hits as they bested the Cubbies at Wrigley Field 9-7. As of right now, the Cubs sit in fourth place in the National League Central Division, 9.5 games behind first. And the Royals sit in last place in the American League Central Division. They're 15 games back. Mike Moustakas grabbed 3 base knocks, helping lead the Reds to victory over the Marlins 5-2. He is among the National League leaders in home runs. Heading into the day, the Reds are atop the NL Central. They hold a comfortable 5-game advantage. And the Marlins sit in last place in the National League East. They're 18.5 games out of first. In the standings, the Brewers sit in third place in the National League Central Division. They trail by 8.5 games, while the Nationals are in second place in the NL East, only a half game back. The Cardinals brought out the brooms in a 3-game sweep as they sank the visiting Buccos 8-6. They now have 5 straight wins. Entering the day's action, the Cardinals are in second place in the NL Central, 5 games back. And the Pirates are at the bottom of the division, 18 games out of first. The D-backs put together 10 total hits as they took care of the Rocks in Colorado 6-2. As of right now, the Rockies sit in last place in the National League West Division. They're over 20 games out of first. And the Diamondbacks are third in the division, 16 games out of first. The Metropolitans launched 3 home runs as they pushed past the Dodgers at Chavez Ravine 7-6. Heading into the day, the Dodgers sit in first place in the National League West Division, yet they currently hold a spot in the race for the National League wild card. And the Mets are in third place in the NL East, only a game and a half back. The San Diego Padres allowed only 5 hits as a staff as they defeated the visiting Fightin' Phils 5-3. At the start of the day, the Padres are atop the NL West, yet they currently lead the race for the National League wild card. and the Phillies sit in fourth place in the National League East Division, 4.5 games back. And that's what's going on around baseball heading into today's action. Join us again tomorrow for more updates from around Major League Baseball.
Seen its share of great moments through the years. A look at the Oakland Coliseum. Tonight, it's an in-division matchup from the AL West between the Seattle Mariners and the Oakland A's. It's A's Baseball coming up next. Frankie Montas gets the call for game one of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
Stepping up is Sam Haggerty, and we are set for baseball here
leading
this evening.
Tonight for Seattle, the left fielder, Sam Haggerty.
First offering, and a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. And Dan Dero, this Oakland ball club entering play here tonight. They've come in losers of 7 of their last 10 games, but did earn the victory last time out.
Yeah, Matty V, and you know what, Dero, this is when you really get tested. They call it the dog days of August for a reason. When you're struggling like this team is right now, the games get long, the schedule gets long, and you start looking forward towards the end of the season.
Yeah, but you got to find a way, Dan. You know as well as I do. You got to look in the mirror. You're playing for way more, especially the way this team is on. Underachieved, you got to keep grinding. You got to find a way to put your foot on the gas and show up to the yard every day ready to go.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Donnie Walton comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Expected to get a little cooler as we go on, but the temperature at game time, 68 degrees. Fastball, and that thing got up there at 95 miles an hour, a ball and a strike. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew working this one. Behind the plate is Eric Summersgill.
You know what, Dan? I'm always baffled when Eric Summersgill's behind the dish because he has a tendency to favor one side of the plate.
You know, that's one of the things I think pitchers get a little bit frustrated with the E-train at time. It's like, hey, if you're going to give me that inside quarter, give it to me, but don't keep moving the dish around on me all game.
Hit out towards second. He's got it. And there's out number two. Digging in next, Kyle Seager. Prior history in this matchup, just a 3-for-13 batting line. Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. And he lays off there, 1-0. And this one's too far inside, ball two. Now the 2-0 home. Just underway here in Oakland. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1. And we'll have the first base runner of the ball game here as that misses, and it's a two-out walk.
Batting fourth, the right fielder, Mitch
Haniger. Stepping in now is Mitch Haniger. He comes in after a day of rest yesterday, so we'll see if it did him any good. Now the first pitch. A ball and no strikes.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
The 1-0 is taken for ball two.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
Seager is off of first with two away. This one's down to third. Chapman has it cleanly. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Mariners leave one. Mariners nothing. A's coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. James Paxton, the left-handed Canadian, gets the starting assignment here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Yeah, Matt, his last start wasn't a particularly good one. Lasted five innings and ended up taking the loss. He's a much better pitcher than that, and I think he's looking to at least, hopefully, pitch into the sixth or seventh inning in this one.
Here's Elvis Andrus now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Shortstop, Elvis Andrus.
Here it comes now to Andrus. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. And fellas, you take a look at these Seattle Mariners at the start of play here tonight. They've been fairly punchless of late, losing last time out and, in fact, dropping six of their last seven.
Yeah, Matty V, and you know what, D-Row, this is when you really get tested. They call it the dog days of August for a reason. When you're struggling like this team is right now, the games get long, the schedule gets long, and you start looking forward towards the end of the season.
Yeah, but you got to find a way, Dan. You know as well as I do. You got to look in the mirror. You're playing for way more, especially the way this team is underachieved. You got to keep grinding. You got to find a way to put your foot on the gas and show up to the yard every day ready to go.
First pitch on its way. Tony Kemp stands in as he looks at ball one here. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. The head-to-head with James Paxton, he's gone 4-for-9. The 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. One out, nobody on. And he'll just lay this one in there, 3-1.
Four-seam heater right down the middle. I would have thought he popped a clutch on that pitch.
And he missed with that one. It's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by. But on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
So a runner at first with one out now. And that means Matt Chapman will dig into the plate. He's set, and the pitch taken, and that one catches the bottom part of the strike zone. Chapman has all the necessary skills to play great defense on the left side of the infield, and it makes him really fun to watch. He can pick it with the best of them, but what sets him apart is the huge arm. It's accurate, it's incredibly strong, certainly has the ability to uncork a throw and beat a runner when he needs to, and it's impressive to watch.
Yeah, anybody that has the ability to go to their backhand and to absolutely fire a cannon across the infield is a huge asset to have.
The next 0-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Haggerty is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. Hitless in four tries in the ball game yesterday.
Olson.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. A runner on first with two away. quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. The A's strand one, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Now at the plate, Ty France. In his career versus this pitcher, he's gone 2-for-5.
Ty France.
Here's the first pitch.
Hey.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
And this is high, a ball and a strike. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind 1-2.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball, you can tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Slider, and that's hit on the ground towards second. Scooped up. Throw is in time for the first out of the second.
Batting six, the second baseman, Dylan Moore.
So stepping in is Dylan Moore, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. First pitch on the way. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Laureano is there now, and he has it, two gone. Batter will be Shed Long Jr. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he fouls this one off. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at one. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
3-2, a full count to the Mariners' designated hitter. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Hit in the air down the left field line. But it drops foul down there in the home bullpen area. He takes it to the opposite field, high and deep to left. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
Left fielder really never had a chance at that one at all. It was over his head before he knew it, bouncing off the base of the wall for an easy double. Those are the kind of shots anyone would feel good about.
And that'll bring in Tom Murphy, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He'll enter play here with that average down in the low 200s. 13 home runs and 37 RBIs. One and oh, here it is. Aye. in the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The 2-2. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
This is foul right side. Fouled off. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing and a liner. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Payoff pitch on its way. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks in bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
So next to bat will be Jake Fraley. He brings an average in the 260s into this one. First delivery to him. As the fastball is swung on and missed. Good location down at the knees for strike one.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Long over at second. Murphy at first, two out in the inning. A ball and two strikes now.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
The 1-2 pitch. Got him swinging. Made him chase outside the zone that time, and that puts an end to the inning. Mariners leave a couple. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Ready now is Ramon Laureano.
Leading off.
He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
Number 22.
And now the first pitch. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Now a swing and he gets him to pop it up. Coming in is Haniger, and this is going to be a foul ball. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. 1-2 as the changeup had him out in front there. Fouled away. Here's another 1-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Batting six.
So now it's Mark Canna. The head-to-head with James Paxton. He has a 3-for-12 line. He also has one home run. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. The windup and the 0-1. Paxton has become known as a guy that's tough to take deep. So many starting pitchers find themselves snake bitten by the gopher ball, but he really limits that. Bottom of the second here with no score. And he takes a called strike two. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away, so now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
This is on the ground over to first. And there are two away now.
Batting seven.
Bases are empty here with two away.
Yeah.
And up next, the ever-versatile Chad Pinder. And now, pitch on the way. A bit high there. A ball and no strikes. Popped him up. France has a play. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the A's. We'll move to the third with no score. So back to the top of the Seattle lineup, digging in, Sam Haggerty. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout, this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Ball three to a leadoff hitter that can run. Not the greatest way to start this right here. I think right now you really have to start pouring some pitches into that strike zone.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
And don't forget, he lost his last time out, so he wants to get off on the right foot here. The last thing he wanted was to walk the leadoff man.
So now into the box is Donnie Walton, grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
One ball, no strikes the count. A runner at first with no outs here. Now a bunt attempt here. Throw on to first, so the sacrifice is successful. One gone now in the Mariners' third inning. And into bat next, the third baseman, Kyle Seager. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Third inning, no score to this point. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And that one yanked just foul. That's in there. Base hit. Haggerty rounds the corner and is headed home. And he's safe at the plate as they take the lead.
Hey, this team's been in a pretty bad funk, D-Row. They've had a difficult time scoring and winning any game. So to strike early, that RBI single right there is awfully big.
Yeah, and hopefully the pitcher's able to breathe a sigh of relief, Dan, like you say all the time. Give me some early runs and let me relax and attack the zone.
I've always said, D-Row, you score me six runs, I'm going to win a lot of games.
Mitch Haniger the next to bat, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. The 1-0 home. A swing and a miss, strike one.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Now the 2-1 is strike two swinging.
Two balls, two strikes.
And it's fouled away. Seager leads off first with one away. A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Ready with the 0-1.
I got a ball, one strike.
Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
Nope, that's
it. Splitter, 2-2. Hot shot on the ground is short. Andrus fields it cleanly. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. Mariners get one on this swing by Kyle Seager. We play 2.5. It's 1-0 Seattle. Leading off the inning, it'll be Stephen Piscotty. They'll look to spark the offense and even things up.
Stephen Piscotty.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. That misses. It's 2-0 now to the Oakland right fielder. Paxton's ready. Here it is. And a very low strike there. Trying to speed up the game, perhaps. It's 2-1. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Here's the pitch. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
He froze him on the fastball there. Stephen Piscotty is retired for the first out here in the bottom half of the third.
Murphy.
In at the plate is Sean Murphy. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Still plenty to be desired in terms of batting average down in the 180s entering play. 13 home runs, 39 driven in. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Three and oh now.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the 9-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. And oh, that should have been ball four there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Hit well on the ground to first. Fielded cleanly. Oh, and the throw is over his head. And now, oh, this ball's going to wind up out of play. And a big mistake there. So definite problems on that last play, and they'll hit the first baseman for the error. Striding in for Oakland, Elvis Andrus. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. First pitch on its way. lifted in the air out towards left center. Long run for the center fielder, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Next up for the A's, Tony Kemp trying here to plate the tying run from second.
Tony Kemp.
From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Whoa, that's
not the best change up there, an easy take. Up top, it's 2-0. Swing and a miss, 2-1.
One of my pet peeves in the game. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. You're all over the heater. How are you late on that fastball?
The count now at 2-2. Rolled slowly down the third baseline. Throw won't get him at first. An infield single, and it's first and third now.
Now's a good time for your pitcher to take a deep breath. He still has the lead, although it probably doesn't feel like it. So he can't worry about how he got into this mess. He just has to figure out how to get out of this mess.
And that'll bring in Matt Chapman, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Ready with the 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2.
The count doesn't mean much to this batter. He's all in. He's not concerned with striking out, so he's going to get his A swing off.
0-2, here it is. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. Back with more on this Monday night after this. A's strand a couple. It remains 1-0. Back at the Oakland Coliseum, and before we go much further, let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Mariners manager Scott Servais during the break about his team's offensive performance so far, and overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've already worked out 3 walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Now with the plate is Dylan Moore. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
The second baseman, Dylan Moore.
Let's go. Cut this guy down.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
Looks like a right-hander's gotten up to throw now in the Oakland pen. The windup and the 1-0 pitch.
Ball, that's out.
Like to see him be looking to the opposite field with this next swing. Pitcher's trying to work you away.
Down the first baseline. He's got it. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
The bat, number 4.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Shedlong Jr. He doubled his last time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
No balls and a strike to count. Nothing in one count. Here it comes.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on, and if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch, and he fouls this one off.
Let's
ready with another 0-2. Inside and high with that one. One ball, two strikes.
That fastball really got away from him there. That's kind of a red flag for me that he's starting to tire or wear down a little bit. The first thing that goes is location and then your mechanics. We'll see if this continues.
Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. He makes the throw to first. Two down.
The catcher, number two.
Stepping in once again is Tom Murphy. Worked a walk his first time up. And the pitch. Swing and a laser off into foul territory. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Hit back up the middle. Andres to his left. He's there. Rowanda Olson will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. Mariners are down in order, but they're on top 1-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and here comes the first baseman, Matt Olson.
Matt Olson.
Paxton steps into his windup. Here comes the pitch. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Strike taken up in the zone.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
2-1 to the A's first baseman. All even now, 2-2. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now, just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
And that'll bring in Ramon Laureano, as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. Struck out in his first at-bat. The 1-0 home.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
Henniger will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning.
Up next.
Now into the box. Mark Canha. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Here's the first pitch. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now. No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. 2-1 after the foul ball there. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Fouled off. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, you never want to issue a free pass if you can help it. But when a hitter like that digs in, you'd rather he's standing at first than driving a ball out of here and erasing your one-run lead.
Runner at first with two gone in the inning. And up next, the ever-versatile Chad Pinder. From the stretch.
Nope. That's in there.
Canha, the runner at first with two gone. A ball and a strike.
Hey, I don't mind that batter taking that strike right there. He's walked a couple people early in this game. Got to find out if he can find the zone. If he wants to walk them all in, we'll take it.
One pitch is a knuckle curve. He's in the hole now, 1-2. And that one got a piece of him.
Well, he's really been good all game long until that one. He was definitely not trying to hit a guy when he's got two strikes on him. It just appeared that it got away from him.
Up next, Stephen Piscotty, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. First delivery to him. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Especially after drilling the last guy up at the plate, that's just a great job to get your mechanics back onto you and establish yourself back in the strike zone.
Two down, runners at first and second. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. This is line to left, and Haggerty's under it to make the play and retire the side. A's strand a couple. They still trail 1-0. Birch Smith, the 6'4" right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the
number
pitching.
46. Birch Smith.
So now to the plate, Jake Fraley comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game.
Jake Fraley.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Fraley, just 24 years of age. He's in his third season as a major league player. The 1-0 is swung on and missed, and that's strike one.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it.
Whoa, he was swinging out of his shoes on that changeup. Must have looked real good coming in, but a different story once it got near the plate.
2-2 the count. Into the windup and the pitch. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And that's in there, base hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. And the Mariners have something going right away. It's a leadoff double.
It's a grinder, AB. 3-2 changeup, and he's able to stay back and drive it for a base hit. Sometimes you just got to tip your hat.
In now, Sam Haggerty. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. It was a walk in his last trip. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. One run on three hits and one error in the ballgame for Seattle. Swing and a liner. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit. The runner scores from second.
Now batting the shortstop, Johnny Walton.
Into the box, Donnie Walton. As he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. He laid down a sacrifice bunt in his last trip. is set. Here's the 0-1. Nobody out, runner on first. One and two, the count to the Mariners shortstop. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
That strikeout was all about setting the hitter up with hard stuff. You can see the first three pitches are coming in fast, and then he slows it down on the fourth pitch, knowing the hitter is sort of conditioned for the hard stuff. Yet another way to upset a hitter's timing.
Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. Singled last time up. And he misses with it, one and one. Runner at first here, one man out. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Runners off for second. Oh, behind the bat. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there. So one down with a pair of runners aboard. And up next, the corner outfielder, Mitch Haniger. Set, here it comes.
From an offensive standpoint, this is where you got to push the throttle right here. You've had a couple hits in the inning. You got a 1-0 count leverage. Let's see if he can gap something.
Little dribbler up the first baseline. Haggerty on second. Seager at first, one gone. A ball and two strikes to Mitch Haniger.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Hit back toward the mound. Scooped up. A jumping catch at second for one. Relay to Olsen. They turn the double play, and that retires the side. Like clockwork, a 4-6-3 double play to end the threat. Back with more Monday Night Baseball following this. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, I talked to manager Bob Melvin during the break about his thoughts on the A's hitters to this point. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Bottom of the inning now, and next to hit is the catcher, Sean Murphy.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way, but this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first out.
Jumped all over that first pitch of the inning, and he didn't miss it. Just wasn't able to steer it in a direction that resulted in a leadoff hit.
So Elvis Andrus, the next to bat, as he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1. Andrus in an 0-2 hole here.
His command has been outstanding so far, hitting nearly all of his spots, and that's been a big factor why he's been so successful up to this point.
He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. That misses, says the home plate umpire. One and two. Where it misses, I'm not quite sure. Fouled away. Here he comes again. 1-2.
Nope. That's inside.
Bases are empty. One man out. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back, off-speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Center fielder giving chase. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now back.
Base is empty, two away. Tony. And striding toward the plate to hit next, Tony Kemp. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one.
Hey, a two-out walk right here would be the tying run to the plate. Even though it's early on, we've got a guy on deck that has a lot of pop.
Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. A's are gone in order. They're still down. It's 2-0. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Ty France.
The first baseman, Ty.
Here it comes.
Well, if you could throw it for a strike consistently, a first pitch changeup is effective. Hitters are almost never looking for it.
Swung on and missed that strike two.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
Regardless of the result right here, to be down 0-2 and work it back to an even count, got to feel like it's a win for the offense.
And it looked like the fastball got away from him there.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
But this will be speared at third, and that was self-defense all the way. One gone. So next to hit is Dylan Moore. He comes in 0-2 thus far. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. And it's a foul ball. One out, nobody on.
That's a ball.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Line to second where it's caught there for out number two.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Shed Long Jr.
Next, it'll be Shed Long Jr. His prior history versus this arm, not a big sample size, 0-1. First offering on its way. Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's fouled away. Here it comes on 1-1. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Sharp ground ball toward the hole. And that is through into right field for a single. So we'll go at least one at bat deeper into the top of the sixth after that two out success.
Tom Murphy.
At the plate now, Tom Murphy. And he's a bit tardy there on the first pitch fastball. It's nothing and one. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Cue shot here out towards short. And Andrus will not be able to get there. It's a base hit.
Boy, D-Roll, that ball wasn't hit very hard, but when you're struggling now like this guy is, any knock is a good tuck.
Yeah, 100%. He doesn't usually get those. He has to square it up mid-barrel to find a way to get a knock. He hasn't had much luck this year, but he'll take that any day.
Standing in now, Jake Fraley. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Two balls and no strikes.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Man, the Mariners have been looking for that big hit pretty much all game long. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure would be a great time.
Now the 2-1.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
Long at second, Murphy on at first with two down. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
And now, Sam Haggerty, one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Bases juiced now with two away. Now the first pitch. As he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. Here's the 1-0. 1-1.
Hey, that's the modern game right now. North-south. Elevate that high fastball and bury stuff in the dirt. Completely different from the east-west we came up playing.
The set and the 1-1. Now a little looper down the left field line. And this is down for extra bases, and it might chase everybody home. And not in time as the run scores.
You know, D-Row, hitting in the leadoff spot, you're not going to get very many opportunities now to drive in some runs, but that's a big two RBI base hit.
Yeah, when you see ducks on the pond, Dan, your eyes light up. I don't care if you're hitting first in the lineup or eighth in the lineup. You grind out in that bat and try and get the runs on the board for your team.
Now pitching for the A's.
New pitcher set to take over now. It's the right-hander Sergio Romo that gets the call.
Romo!
Stepping in now, Donnie Walton. And he puts it on the ground to second. And how about that right out of the bullpen? A ground ball on one pitch, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. Part of the order, 3, 4, and 5 coming up. The Mariners are on top, 4-0. So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman to start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
Yeah, I think if I'm the hitting coach right here, Matty, I'm telling the offense to get aggressive. Just seems like we've been going too deep in counts, and this guy has got exploding stuff on the mound. So I would tell them get overly aggressive on a heater in the middle of the plate early.
As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone, it's ball one. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Called a strike on the inside part of the plate, 2-1.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
Cut fastball that time, but he doesn't bite, and now it's 3-1. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now, 3-2. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
And that'll bring up Matt Olson, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Paxton comes set, first pitch on its way. Starts him out with the knuckle curve, and he swings through it for strike one.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in his zone to induce a ground ball double play.
A runner at first with no outs here. And there's ball one. And he fouls this one off. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out. A strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Into the box now, Ramon Laureano. Moore is calling for it. Two gone.
Now back.
Next, it'll be Mark Canna. It was a walk in his last trip.
Canna.
Here's the first pitch. Chapman leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. And he struck him out. His seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. One left for Oakland. They trail here 4-0. At the plate now is Kyle Seager. Head-to-head numbers against Sergio Romo. He's 1-for-4.
Kyle Seager.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. A ball and no strikes. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Swung on and missed. 1-1. One ball, one Here it comes.
Well, that backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's a very effective pitch. If you can hit the outside corner of that pitch, it's unhittable.
To 2-2 now.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline in that. You get a count in your favor and you swing at a pitch that bad? Not good.
The 2-2.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Another try at 2-2. Popped him up. Olson in foul ground. And that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting. Right field.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Mitch Haniger. He was a double play victim last time around.
He doesn't have to worry about that in this situation, Matty. No one on base right now. Try and get something up so you can drive the baseball.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Nope, at the ball.
Good change up there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. Fouled off. One and one, here it is. Good slider there, gets a swing and miss.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late, and you can't even put a good swing on it.
The 1-2 pitch. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch, and even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
So here now is Ty France, as he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Swung on and missed.
One and one.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
Two balls and a strike to the Mariners' first baseman. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Two out, nobody on. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. Murphy finds it, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Mariners, but they hold a 4-0 lead. Brendan Brennan gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 60, Brandon Brennan.
Striding in is Chet Hinder. Lifetime versus this pitcher. Not a big sample size, 0 for 1.
Hinder.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. As he'll watch a slider that stays inside for ball one. In for a strike, it's 1-1. Fouled away. Here's a fastball in on the fists, and that'll even things up at 2-2.
When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball, you have to be ready for him to try to run it inside and jam you. Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that now late batter, action that right just fielder. Darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on. And when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
So that'll bring up Stephen Piscotty as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. 0 for 2 for him to this point. Now the 1-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind one and two.
This offense has just been flailing at the plate all game long, so it's no wonder why they've only been able to pick up one hit so far. I'm not seeing much of a game plan from these hitters.
The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Fastball too high, ball four.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Next up is Sean Murphy. Hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
First delivery to him. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. And it's fouled away. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
I got to count 1 and 2.
Piscotty, base runner at first with one out. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The 2-2 one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough go of it at the plate with him. And watching this at-bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you can tell these things and exploit them.
In now, Elvis Andrews, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. That evens it up 1-1. Here it comes now to Andrus.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Pound two balls in, and then get right back outside. Nice pitch.
The 1-2. Swing and a liner, foul and out of play.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Good changeup in the dirt, strike three. And the throw to first ends the inning. Starting to run out of innings here as they are unable to cut into the deficit. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. The Mariners lead it 4-0. Lou Trevino is on now out of the bullpen as he'll make his 70th appearance so far this year.
Lou Trevino.
And now in the box, Dylan Moore. He'll start things out for us here in inning number 8.
Dylan Moore.
Now here's the first offering. Trevino, a right-hander going 6'5". He was selected in the 11th round back in the draft of 2013.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
0-1, here it comes. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Into the box, Shedlong Jr. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. The 1-0 home. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. One out, nobody on. And a breaking ball runs in and gets him, and I doubt there was any intent behind that.
You always want to see the curve break a lot, but this one breaks a little bit too much, comes all the way across the plate and nicks the batter.
At the plate now, Tom Murphy, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. A hit and two tries for him so far. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Murphy is there. And that's the second out of the inning.
Up next for Seattle.
Next for Seattle, Jake Fraley. One for two with a double on the ledger so far. And now the first pitch. As he hits one on a line to left field. A dive, but it's off his glove. The throw to third. And he's safe.
Hey, speed it up. He's safe.
Now back, left fielder, Sam Haggerty.
Now to the plate, here is Sam Haggerty, singled in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and just another simple single to the outfield would be a big one right here. Don't try and do too much. You know there's a potential base open right there. Maybe sit off speed.
Trying to hang a zero, here's the pitch. A little tardy there, no balls and a strike. chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2.
On 0-2 here, he doesn't have to give in with a great pitch to hit. He's got a base open, so he has to focus.
We'll have to press pause as that's strike three to retire the side. Mariners leave a couple. They lead it 4-0.
It ain't no surprise.
Matt McGill is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 36, Matt McGill.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Tony Kemp.
Tony. Yeah.
First pitch on the way. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. And that one misses upstairs, 2-0. Too tight with that one. 3-0. Matt Chapman will be next. That one's in there. 3-1.
Great job of doubling up with a fastball inside. A lot of times you'll see a pitcher go in there, but they won't go back in there a second time. This guy's not afraid to pitch inside.
The 3-1. And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eighth.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Chapman.
So the next to bat will be Matt Chapman. No hits to this point. He's set and the pitch. Right-hander against right-hander as this is a ball 1-0.
Perfect time for a mound visit right here. Just give him a breather, a chance to collect himself and get back to work.
The 1-0 home. And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander is up to throw. Kemp gets his lead at first, nobody out. No offer on that one, 2 balls and a strike.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
The 2-1 on its way. And, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now.
I'm absolutely shocked he took that pitch right there. Right in a wheelhouse, low 90s heater. That's one you got to let go on.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. 2-2 count. Here it comes. Swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch-out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
At the plate, Matt Olson, as he'll take a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. Oh and one, here it comes. And this one's in the dirt, and he'll rein it in as the count moves to 1-2. Runners on first with one down. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Fraley is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Next to dig in, Ramon Laureano. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Hey, that's just a great mix of pitches right there, and that's what this guy's going to do if he's going to keep this team off balance.
Hit out towards second. Reined in. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. The A's strand one. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. J.B. Wendelken enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth.
Wendelken.
All set for the start of the inning, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Donnie Walton.
Donnie Walton.
Here's the first pitch.
1-0.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series, and maybe even the whole week ahead.
Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. And the pitch. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. There's Kyle Seager in the on deck circle. We'll see him next. And a 2-2 sinker falls in there. 3-2 now. Line towards center field. Laureano is right there, one down.
Now batting, the third baseman, Kyle Seager.
And now here is Kyle Seager. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
Way the 0-1 pitch lifted in the air to straightaway center. Laureano is there, two gone.
Now batting right fielder.
So now it'll be Mitch. The four-hole hitter, Mitch Haniger. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. And another foul ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Mariners are down in order, but they're in front 4-0. Domingo Tapia, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen.
Domingo Tapia.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And striding into bat next will be Mark Canna.
Mark Canna.
First pitch on the way. Too high to start the inning. It's 1-0. Tapia, 28 years old. This is his second year as a major leaguer. The 1-0 home.
Hey, even though this guy's a righty hitter, he's going to get pounded with that two-seamer. He needs to make sure he catches this thing out front if he sees that pitch again.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Waiting on it is Haniger. One out.
The left fielder.
Next to stand in is Chet Hinder. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. Now the first pitch.
He'll take that first pitch strike all day long. If they're going to take 0-0, he's going to pound that zone and get ahead. Much more susceptible down 0-1 than 1-0.
And he fouls this one off. The 0-2 delivery. Fouled off.
If you're on the mound right here, why not continue to climb the ladder if he's going to continue to swing at it?
Got him swinging in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Hinder is retired. Two down now.
Now batting. Right fielder.
Now it'll be Stephen Piscotty. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. And he takes ball one. And he looks at a slider in there. 1-1. Two out, nobody on. Fouled away.
Not surprised he's late on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Giving chase is Haniger. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Well, in a quick series like this, you take the first one, you're guaranteed at least a split. They'll take that every single time.
4-0 the score tonight. The M's led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. James Paxton earns win number 7 on the season, permitting only one hit in 6 complete innings. Frankie Montas was only able to work 4 innings as he takes the loss. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Seattle Mariners. 4 runs on 8 hits, 1 error. They left 10 men on base. For the Athletics, no runs, just 1 hit, no errors. They left 8 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 41 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.